Welcome back! My name is ballerscuba. This is Video Games Over Time! We are still in 1985. Today, we're going to talk about The Way of the Exploding Fist. The story of The Way of the Exploding Fist takes us back to Beam Software. We have talked about Beam Software before. They were responsible for the Hobbit video game in 1982. For The Way of the Exploding Fist, Beam Software turned to Greg Barnett. Greg Barnett had previously ported The Hobbit to the Commodore 64. Barnett was joined by Bruce Bailey, David Johnston, and Neil Brennan. The team was inspired by Karate Champ, which we talked about in a previous video. The team decided to make a Japanese martial arts game that used a modified point system. Neil Brennan, who also did some design, composed the soundtrack for the game. He based the soundtrack on Dance of the Yao People, a Chinese instrumental composition from 1952 by Liu Tishan and Mao Yuan. The Way of the Exploding Fist is a fighting game. The player plays a karate fighter who must compete through a series of one-on-one matches, defeating their opponent before moving on to the next stage. To defeat their opponent, the player must complete two yin-yang icons at the top of the screen. A weaker attack will earn the player half a yin-yang, while a decisive blow will earn the player a full yin-yang. Should the opponent get two yin-yangs first, the player will lose. There are a total of 18 different movements that the player can use, including several different kinds of kicks and punches. These are all done with the same button combined with directional inputs. Melbourne House, Beam Software's parent company, published The Way of the Exploding Fist to the Commodore 64 on May 31st, 1985. That is a brief backstory to The Way of the Exploding Fist. With that told, it's time to play the game for ourselves. And here we are in the game. This is The Way of the Exploding Fist. As you can see, Melbourne House's The Way of the Exploding Fist, copyright Beam, 1985. This is an American release, which is why it says UXB Presents. They ended up getting the rights in America for it. But this is the game. We get a nice scene here as I hit the start button, hoping that it just kind of works eventually. We get a nice little scene here. We get a Japanese pagoda. I don't know the name of the arch thing, but that is very Japanese. We got the cherry blossoms. We got Mount Fuji in the background. We have a Japanese style bridge with a pond and then a guy just hanging out meditating. This game, it takes a bit. The one thing that we might notice as we play this game is that everything just kind of takes a while in this game. Everything's just a little bit slow. Like I said, I already hit the start button. I've hit the start button several times now, hoping that it will just kind of move forward. Maybe I have hit the wrong one. There we go. Just kind of hoping for the best to get through the main screen, but it does say that it takes 2 minutes to load as soon as you boot it up. All right, here we are in the game. Let's take over. All right, so we're gonna just kind of go for it. There we go. Good kick there. That is only half a point. What do you gotta do for a full point there? Ah, there we go. That should be a full point. Yeah, there we go. All right, and how did I miss? How did I miss? Also, what is with the screaming? And then just a punch. And I have won. I get my bonus points and we're ready to move on. Boom. Straight sidekick works sometimes. Hey, it worked again. But if I do the same thing twice, I guess it only counts as half. How did I hit? That landed right on his head. All right, let's jump away. I don't understand. I don't understand how that didn't work out for me. Oh, he punched me in the groin. Like, while I was kicking. I call shenanigans. I call shenanigans. I get 4,100 points. It felt like I did not do well. Let's be real here. I did not do well. All right, so we're gonna try that again. Once again, like, shenanigans. I kicked first. And then he's like, no, I'm doing a spin kick, so mine counts for more. I knocked him down, you get half a point. Get him to his knees, half a point. I didn't even hit the button when I punched that first time. And I have lost. Again. 200 points. How dare you? And we get a little bit of music here. Let me try again. There we go. Get a full point that time. I kept trying, but because I was pointed the wrong way, they wouldn't let me kick. Okay. Point and a half and kick. That's enough for the next point. Move on. Alright. Well, I only got like 400 points, I'm not sure. The groin punch, it works every time. What the hell? He can't just groin punch me to victory, can he? There, I hit him right back. And that counts as a full point. How do you decide what's a decisive blow and what's not? All right, now I gotta jump. No. There. No. I'm facing the wrong way. Nope. Groin punch gets me every time. And down I go again. Down I go again. This is not lasting very long. Like, I can't seemingly get through it. All right, we're going to try one more time. Hopefully I can make it past novice, but oh, that's where I even put my name. I do not care. Okay. Yeah, you can use the keyboard for that. Okay. Knock him down half a point. Nope. Nope. Do the kick! Nope, nope. My kick didn't count. I was too close to him. I'm trying to back off. Right, roundhouse kick. Nope. 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 If he's crouched, I can't kick him in the face. Them's the rules. Alright, I've won. Moving on. Give me my 600 points. God. There. Kick him straight on. Kick him straight on! Sometimes it lands, sometimes it doesn't. Depends on if he's decided to do a move yet or not, I think. Alright. I've won. I've gotten a fair amount of points, maybe? Alright, now I'm at first Dan. Which is a real karate thing. We finally got to our second scene. I'm just moving forward sidekicking. It seems to be my best strategy. Unless he blocks or ducks down, but, you know. No, he's found the counter! Kick! Yeah, I'm not gonna be able to beat him. Not gonna be able to beat the first Dan. Nope. Down I go. Jump kick. Everything's just so slow. I have to hold the button down for everything. And yeah, I get less points because I did it slower this time. I can put my initials in, but I don't feel good about any of that. Now we can watch the demo. As you can see, like, they can move a lot faster than I felt I could. Like, I just couldn't do it all that quick. You know, like, yeah, it doesn't feel like we made it very far in the game, but that's pretty much as best as I can hope for, it seems like. So, that is going to be the gameplay, and with the gameplay, it's time to talk about how it holds up today. Playing the game today, I have to say that I am not a fan of the way of the Exploding Fist. I did not have fun playing the Exploding Fist. It just didn't quite hit the mark for me this time, and that's a rare thing for me to say. And I do know that this game does have some loyal fans, so it might just be my opinion, my way of looking at the game, but it just never felt like I had full control of my character, that the rules of the game just didn't function quite right. It was difficult for me to get my character to do what I wanted them to do sometimes. Sometimes they would do something a little weird. I would just move my joystick up and my character would punch, which was not what I expected. But then if I do up and to the side, they would do a very large leap. And then sometimes just start facing the wrong way and I couldn't figure out how to turn them around. But even if I could control my character properly, it was difficult to figure out what constituted a decisive blow versus, you know, basically whatever would give me a half a point. Sometimes the same thing with the same animations would give me two different results. And there would be several times that I would land punches or kicks. At least it looked like I landed them, but the game told me different. For instance, if the guy is on the ground, I apparently cannot kick him in the face, which granted goes against like sport competition rules, but I didn't know if we were doing that in this one. So ultimately, the gameplay for me is the downside. The enemies that you're fighting are difficult, right? You can easily lose to the first person that you fight, easily lose to the second one, and then the third one, I never found a way around. Ultimately, the graphics of the game, I think, are the highlight for a modern gamer. I think the graphics do have a style to them. I think they look nice. I think they held up well. I would honestly say that I did not enjoy the sound of the game. I found the sound of the game grating. I did not like the fact that my characters were basically screaming every time I did a move. That's not the way that I would like that. And I just don't think that the sound held up well at all. In terms of replayability factor, I think the game has a lot of replayability factor for a limited amount of time, simply because you're going to die so quickly, you're going to want to play again because you just aren't going to feel satisfied with what has happened. But at the end of the day, after playing it for a bit, I still feel unsatisfied. It just did not work for me. So in terms of who I would personally recommend this to, it's not a lot of people. I know other people will recommend it, so I have to kind of put that out there that I might be in the minority opinion on this one. But for me, the game really only works if you either have nostalgia for it or you are interested deeply in retro fighting games, particularly ones that are European. Otherwise, I don't think that the majority of modern gamers are going to get a lot of enjoyment out of this game. And that's my modern take on the game. When the game was released, The Way of the Exploding Fist would be very popular. The game was the best-selling computer game of 1985 in the United Kingdom. Across all of Europe, the game would sell a total of 500,000 copies. Critics at the time were very positive about the game. In particular, the sound effects for the game were praised. As time has gone on, the game will still occasionally make best video games of all time lists in the United Kingdom. However, the game is largely unknown outside of Europe. The game would receive ports to other British computers and would receive a remake and sequels. We will keep an eye on these sequels as we continue, if only briefly. As for Beam Software, the company would continue to create video games. We will hear from Beam Software again as we continue. The designers of the game would also continue to create video games. We may hear from some of the designers again as we continue, although perhaps only briefly. That will do it for the story of The Way of the Exploding Fist for now. My name is ballerscuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in our next video when we look in a mirror.